So very good morning to all of you. So friends, we are all now facing the challenge of karma. But with this, there is another challenge, which is assuming an alarming proportion, that is a challenge of infodemic. So that we have seen on the internet, there are so many fake news, how a person can be cured from the coronavirus. And particularly in case of Iran, we have seen that one of the incident because of which a lot of people have died by drinking the ethanol, because it was stated to be the cure for the coronavirus. In Maharashtra, we have seen the issue of the migrant, where the migrant was being given a fake message that the trains are on the Bandra railway station to take them to their villages. Then we have also seen there are so many messages alleged to be coming from the WHO or alleged to be coming from the on behalf of the government of India. So now the issue is, what is the solution for such fake news? How to handle that? So we are coming with few videos on this particular issue, and we are covering various aspects of the fake news. What are the fake news? How the fake news create disastrous impact? How its impact is multiplied? Who generates that? How they are circulated on the internet, and why the impact on the internet is more devastating as compared to the other media? And now the question is, what is the remedy for it? So earlier we have discussed about the legal remedies, but with the legal remedies, there is one limitation. When you go for the legal remedy, the impact is already caused. The damage which could be caused from that particular fake news is caused. So the now issue is, what is the solution for it? So in today, in this present video, we are going to discuss about the liability part. Who would be the person who would be liable for it? The person who created, the person who forwarded, person who is an administrator, or person who is merely putting a comment. So just let me share my PPT on this. So first we are coming about the liability part. Now the question, first liability comes of the creator. Now who is the creator? Who creates the fake news and circulated it on the media so that the people can see. So basically, that is the person who is the creator or who is the author. In other words, the person who is the source of that fake news. The person who creates it and then posts it in the domain would be presumed to be an author. For example, if it is created by someone else but posted by another person, then such person would be liable as an author of that news. He has a criminal as well as a civil liability. The damages can be claimed against him, and FIR can also be registered against him. But when we come to the internet domain, whether it may be possible to trace the author or source, that is one of the biggest challenges. And why it is a challenge? The reason is, when you forward a message a number of times, so what happens? Whether you are in a position to trace the original source may not be. And what happens if a message is forwarded a number of times and the original message has been deleted? You may not be able to get who the person who posted it. And there are other situations as well where you may not be able to find out who the author. For example, when it is posted from outside India, or the person is a technology savvy and he has manipulated the IP address, or he has manipulated in some other way that you cannot find out the source. So the second person who is equally liable than the similar to the author is the person who has forwarded. So in the realm of internet, the person who creates and posts and the person who forwarded, both are at the same platform. The person who has forwarded it would be presumed to be an author. Because when you are forwarding something, you are authenticating the content. When you forward something, you know the source and the liability is on the person who has forwarded it. So, forwarder has a liability which is equivalent to the person who is the author. Next, we have the person who is just putting the comment on. And what type of the comment can be there? Number one, it can be the comment to ratify the news. It can be the comment to promote the news. It can be comment to which is against the news. So when a person is putting the comment which are to ratify or which are to promote, then he is also authenticating the content to the public. Then he is equally liable as an author. Next, we come to the liability of the website. So when we talk about the liability of the website, we can divide all the website into two categories. Category number one is the website which is privately owned. Second are the website which are to which we refer as ISP, intermediaries, or like social networking website, which maintain the data on behalf of third parties. So first let us talk about the liability of the website. So if it is a private website and some material is posted, the website owner is liable as an author. Even if he claimed that he has not put the message and message has been put by someone else, still he would continue to remain as an accused, as a conspirator. So that means if someone else has put the message and this website owner has allowed it, then both would be prosecuted for conspiracy. Now coming to the second category of the internet service provider, they are also liable as the abettor under section 109 of the IPC. But they have the exemption under section 79A of the IT Act from the prosecution. But this exemption also has the two riders. Rider number one, that they have to block it immediately the moment it is informed by the agency of the government. The rider number two, that they have to preserve the relevant evidence and the metadata relating to that post. If they fail, even on a single account, either they do not remove it when they are being told to remove, or they do not provide the information, then they are equally liable as an abettor for the prosecution. So now let us come to the few judgments. First, we have the judgment of the Madras High Court in the SVE Shekhar versus the Inspector of Police. When the court has held that the forwarded message is equal to accepting the message and endorsing the same. So a person who is forwarding the fake news is equally liable as the originator of the message. Then we have another judgment on the role of the administrator. And role of the administrator is not liable. But again, we have to see it from social media to social media. For example, in case of WhatsApp, where a person is putting a message, the administrator hardly has any control. But in case of the social media website like the Facebook, administrator may or may not have control. So first category where they are freely, they can be posted freely, the administrator may not be liable because he do not have a control. But coming to the second category where the administrator is approving the message, so then he has a control, then he would be liable. So these are the liabilities of the person who are posting it. So kindly be very cautious in forwarding any message. If you are forwarding any message, you are equivalent to the author, you are liable for the prosecution. So friends, on this account, if you have any query, you can always send your comment and suggestion on this. And also you can follow me on my social media links where you will get all the information about our video and webinars. So our next video would be tomorrow. That would be particularly on how the fake news are created and what are the solutions for it. Then we will come with the what are the legal remedies? Because the social remedies are more important than the legal remedies. Because the legal remedies only give you an outcome which is sort of postmortem, prosecution. But social remedy can give you the solution to blow them. So thank you. Thank you very much. Eu vou colocar o meu e-mail.